The church crouches in the crook of Dead Man's Curve, like an old leather catcher's mitt. After the burial, huddled on the hill, Daddy read her will then and there. Now my Jebbo didn't have a lot, but what she had was what we got, and she bequeathed me her genuine leather pocketbook. A bone bag that dangled off her wrist for years, like a growth, a bunion or something. You'd have thought she was hauling state secrets, or another family's fortune, the way she policed that purse. Set it down. Might as well have been kiss my ass in that woman's mind. Lumbering back to the car, I didn't get far before I knelt down in the Johnson grass and exposed her Tennessee tote sack to daylight. Chiclets spilled when I clicked open the clasp. A vial of pills rolled out on the grass. Butter rum lifesavers. A narrow tooth comb. Chapstick. Shed keys. A birthday card she'd gotten from me. Some wadded up Kleenex. Double mint gum. What I really wanted was a rubber change purse. It's probably now sitting on the floorboard of the hearse. It was red, with a slit down the middle. She'd squeeze it open, take her pointer and thumb, and secure the coins down into my palm at offering time, when they passed the plate at church. But it was there in the side zip pocket, where I found a secret she thought she'd buried. A love letter from a farmhand, Howard McDaniel. I love you too, smeared in the margin of the yellowed note. Her purse gaped open there in the grass, the contents exposed. I felt like I'd stolen her clothes. This woman who swore she was never naked before her own husband.